Hi, my name is Phoebe He. I am a curriculum developer at Oracle. In this demo, I will show you what webform rules can do and how to create a simple webform rule. The Travel Request App application we will use for this demo automates a simple process for submitting and approving travel expenses. The employee submits a travel request, and approval rules determines whether this request needs manual approval by the manager based on the total travel request amount. If the manager rejects the request, it goes back to the employee. Otherwise, it is approved, and the request is saved. Let's take a look at how this application will look to the end user. Assume you have deployed the Travel Request App application. Let's log into the business process workspace as Yihanming, an employee. From the application view, he selects Travel Request Process to kick off the process. The Travel Request form opens. He has to fill in his name, the date, trip details such as where he's going and why, and expense details such as expected airfare and hotel expenses. You can recognize some basic webform design elements here, such as text fields, tabs, drop-down menus, and radio buttons. It's not obvious from looking at the form, but several fields have webform rules, making this a dynamic webform. Let's explore these rules one by one. For example, there are rules that dynamically populate the list of the options in both the country and city drop-down menus based on current values in the database. In fact, the city fields dynamically populate the list of cities based on the value you've chosen in the country field. There is another webform rule that displays the customer name field if and only if you choose customer visit, so you can enter the customer name. And there is also a webform rule that automatically calculates total amount based on the sum of amounts you enter on the expense details tab. In fact, you cannot manually input a value in the total amount field. That field is grayed out. Only the rule can write to that field. These are just a few examples of what webform rules can do. In this demo, you've seen that webform rules can dynamically populate the list of options in a drop-down menu, display fields when certain options are selected, and perform calculations. You can also use webform rules to pre-populate fields in a form based on the current user, clear all the fields in a form with a single click, and much more. Now that you have a basic understanding of what webform rules can do, I'd like to show you how simple it is to create a rule, specifically the rule that displays the customer name field when the user selects the customer visit option. In Business Process Composer, assume you have created the travel request form and added the fields shown here. Notice that the default setting for the customer name field has been set to not visible. This means that, by default, it will not be displayed. Recall that you want this field to be visible if the user selects customer visit. To create webform rule, start by clicking the rules button to open the rules editing page. Click the plus sign to create a new rule. Name the rule and type a brief description to remind you what this rule does. In the rule field, enter the JavaScript code to make the customer name field visible if customer visit is selected. First, check whether the customer visit option has been selected in the purpose of visit field. If so, set the visible property of the customer name field to true. Otherwise, set it to false. To test how the rule works, click the Test button. In the Purpose of Visit field, select Training. The customer name field should not show up. Now, select Customer Visit. The customer name field appears. Your web form rule works. Hopefully, you now understand what web form rules can do and how to create a simple web form rule. I'm Phoebe He. Thanks for watching.